Hey peeps, Sara here from Sparrow Springs, and today is the first part of a series about mixing colors. So mixing colors can be a little bit difficult if you're not used to it. So in a lot of these videos, I recommend using a very limited color palette. Now you can be as limited as just using red, yellow, and blue of some sort. But in this case, I'm also adding a green and a black. So just to kind of give you an idea of how to achieve different colors without having like a whole huge palette of like 120 different colors. Now in a lot of these I'll be using watercolors just because that's what I have available, but a lot of these techniques will still apply for acrylics and other paints and stuff. So just something to keep a note of. So let's jump into it. Okay, peeps, I want to talk a little bit about mixing some colors here, and today we're going to be talking about mixing the perfect blue. And there's a lot of different things that go into what it really boils down to is just experimenting with the colors that you have. And this is where I talk a little bit about having a limited color palette. And while having more colors can be more convenient, it is also very essential to learn how to mix colors on a limited palette. You'll understand how color works so much faster, and to be perfectly honest, like having some knowledge of color theory does also help. So I'm just gonna try and pull some different tones in a blue, and today I'm gonna be using ultramarine blue just because it's what I have on the palette, but I think you'll be surprised at just the different kinds of colors that we can get from that one blue out of the tube. So I'm using Grumbachers, and today I have on my palette a phthalo green, ultramarine blue, alizarin crimson, cadmium yellow, and an ivory black. Now this is from a cheaper set of watercolors that I had, and I really liked their version of their Prussian blue, but you can kind of see where like the quality was a little odd in the sense like it almost had like a black breaking out, and the pigment wasn't very even in a lot of places. I mean, I got kind of an even coat on this one, but this one was just literally laying down the pigment on the paper. So like it was a bummer that these watercolors didn't work super well, but I loved their Prussian blue. So I mean, I'm gonna try and recreate this, and we'll see what I have, if I can get some close to that with what I have on my palette. So I've got my colors here, and I've got a little bit of water, and I'm just gonna start mixing. So obviously, like, I might leave this a little bit lighter in tone. Now I'm mixing with watercolors, but most of the same principles apply to acrylic. I don't have much experience with oil painting. However, with things like acrylic, the thing to keep in mind is that when it dries, it generally dries darker. Okay, let's just see what my pigment looks like here. Okay, I gotta add in a lot of pigment here just to get a little bit closer to that saturation of color. A little better. So I have kind of my basis here on my tone that I'm starting with. This is just my starting base. So I'm going to kind of keep track of what I'm adding. Now I'm getting the sense in this one that there is a little bit more of kind of a greenish tone happening in here. So I'm going to start just by adding in little bits of my phthalo green. And you saw how much pigment I needed to add to this water palette. So let's just see kind of what adding that little bit. I can already see that the tone has changed. So let's just see what this does for us. Oh, wow. That pretty much did most of it. So this was plus phthalo green. I'm gonna let this dry really quick, but let's just take a quick comparison here. It does look to be a little bit more green than my original, but here, let's let it dry. Okay, so I've got it dry, and it does appear to be a little bit more on the green side, just ever so slightly. But at the same time, I would say that was already a pretty close match. So, I mean, sweet. At least I don't have to worry about that too much. But now let's say if I wanted to pull this in a different direction, though. Now, if I wanted this to be darker, for example, I mean, most people's reaction would be to add black. But black is going to make it a kind of a different tone. So why don't we actually pull some of this off into a different tray? And we'll do a little experiment here. And we'll just add a touch of black. So it almost adds kind of like a grungy tone to it. So, I mean, if that's what you're going for, that's great. But say you wanted it to be a little bit richer in depth of color, I would actually probably use something more like alizarin crimson. So let's just do that and make sure I don't add too much. I might have to come back and add some more of my ultramarine in here. Because that is going to pull it just slightly more towards the warmer palette. But you see, you get a little bit more of that richer, rich, deep tone in there. So let's just mark this. So this was here, plus ivory black, and this one was here, plus alizarin crimson. Now, say I like this grungy tone, but I don't want it to be so green. Maybe I want to like pull it back and mute it a little bit more. So when I want to mute something, but kind of keep the, but keep that vibrance and whatnot, you're going to pull it more towards the complementary color. So you would actually add its complement, which would be more of an orange color. So let's do this one, and we'll add a little bit of cadmium yellow. And we did already add some alizarin crimson, but we're gonna add just a little bit more to pull it more towards that complement. Just a little bit. So you almost get more of this gray, muted kind of blue. And the amazing part is, that's without adding any sort of black at all, but it really, adding the complement really just kind of pulls back that saturation. But if you do it carefully, it won't end up brown and muddy. So that's just a brief example of some different colors that you can pull from a limited color palette. So, I mean, these are just these five different colors, and look at the variations in blue that we already have. And you started with an ultramarine blue, which seems like a very one-dimensional kind of color, but look at the depth that you can get from it. So definitely try experimenting with a more of a limited color palette and just play with colors, because you can achieve so many different tones.
Thanks for watching. If you like this video, make sure you comment, like, subscribe, all of the above. And stay tuned for more videos. Get on my email list if you want to learn even more about new stuff that I got coming up. So I'll see you later, peeps.